Slayer, 7 Days to Die with Silver Blade.
damn it, son of a... Ouch.
You must remember to...
Hey, Miles Power!
Don't you feel foolish?
Greetings, minions, intergalactic survivalists, and fellow gamers. This is Silverblade playing Imperion Galactic Survival Alpha 5.5.1. I believe that there's a new update for 6 that just came out. Well, for me it was yesterday. But we're not doing 6 just yet. We're going to wait for the official release on that. This is episode 11, and as you can see, those tomatoes just come up, pop right in there. So that's a nice thing. So, in this episode, well, first let me just get back to what I had done between last episode and this one. I did a bunch of iron mining, as you may have seen at the last end of the previous episode. And I got a bunch, and it's refining right now. In fact, I can show you some of that right now. If I can hit the right buttons. So right there, good chunk, and we still got a little ways to go. Well, I probably ain't gonna finish all that, but it might continue through, I don't know. But I got a good deal of goodness in there, and we're just kind of waiting for this to process through. But I can't think of your name right now. You've been busting my chops about my hover vehicle. Begins with a T. And I'm sorry, my memory for names is not all that great. It usually takes, you know, maybe a half dozen interactions before it's locked in into my head. It's like T-A-R... Targus. I think that's your name. You've been busting my chops on my hover vehicle. We're going to correct that today. See, it took me a little bit to try to get the name out there, but yeah, I got you, Targus. Anyway, we're going to get a new hover vehicle started. But I'm not going to do it from scratch. I'm going to do it from my blueprints, show you what the dung beetle will be and how well it is at mining and all that. We're also going to try to see about expanding the garden and getting that taken care of. So let's get things started on getting the dung beetle going. Alright, so I am going to need... Let me get to this menu first. Alright, I'm going to need 361 iron ingots. So we'll take like half of that. We're going to need 278 copper ingots. So we will take like... I think it was 278. Is that what I said it was? I think that's what it was. Yep. And then 238 cobalt. So 238. There we go. And how much silicon? 137. Alright, that's easy enough. Oops. Now how much iron did I need again? 361. Alright, so we got just enough and then some. Alright, so what we do... Now, here's another thing that you can do, is you can take your extra weapons and certain building items. Not all of them will work. And you can actually just drop them in here, and they'll be broken down based on what their elemental composition is into here. Which is kind of a nice way of getting rid of junk. Really. Alright, so 361 iron, 278 copper, 238 cobalt, and 137 silicon. Start production. So before the end of this episode, we will have a new hover vehicle. Now, while we're doing that, let me check my level. I'm level 18, so that's good. Hover vessel. Scroll down here. Okay, we unlock the drill turret. So, what do we need to build a drill turret? We need an advanced constructor. Great. Alright, so I need two power coils, which I do not have. I have none there. Let's see, did I store any up in here? I don't see any. And yes, I'm a little bit lacking in power coils, it seems. What does it take to make one? Restrum and Zescosium, which I have scant amounts of that. Alright. So what we can do is we'll just focus on getting this started as best as we can. We'll do some harvesting first. And get the fibra. And some wheat. Or wheat. And then some corn. As I like to call them, poo tracers. One of just a rare few foods that reincarnates itself. Yeah, you really, really wanted to know that, huh? Alright, so what do we got in here? We got some spoiled food. We're gonna leave. Oh, that probably reset the timer. Oh. Okay, that's. Okay, so these should be alright for spoilage. These will take a little longer. I'm gonna hold on to the wheat, drop in the fiber. And up there. So, in about 7 minutes or so, we'll have 20 spoiled food. In 4 minutes, we'll have 4 to add to that. We are gonna need one. Let's see. Did I store them down here? I think we need one corn sprout because I think there was a missing spot out here. And indeed, there is. So we'll take care of that. There we go. So that's all growing. Those are all growing. Those are all growing. Now I'm thinking of instead of expanding out this way, I might just expand out this way because we already have these supports here for the light bars across here. We can mirror it onto the other side here and use these to support the light frames for over there. That's what I'm thinking. And everything should be fine. So we're going to need to go in and get some blocks. I think I might have some stored up in here. And I do. Got some growing plots. We're going to need more of those, obviously. Let's see. Yeah. See, if you take these, like, I got these extra multi-tools, extra chainsaws, the old drill. You can take these and drop them into here, and it'll break them down into components that you can use, like, if you're short on something. It'll help you with that, I guess. Get the block out of your face. Let's see. Try making a few of those. I ain't gonna make a whole lot, but probably think only just 2. So we can get a couple of those going. At least, yeah. Get that going. First we need to build out, and that will require picking that up, unfortunately. So let's see, so 1, 2, 3, can't see worth a damn on this, 1, 2, 3, and then we're on. Radio. Alright, so let's anchor this to the ground, sorta, kinda, if we can. And I'm trying to remember if there isn't a squat command, is there? Dang it. Let's see. Click, shift. There we go. I kinda wanna pair it. Well, you know, I probably ought to just do it all the way across here. There's no need to crawl underneath the base. Is this right? 1, 2, 3, yep, okay. Thought I measured it out right. Tool out, if I can find which one it is. There we go. Actually, we'll just disassemble. There we go. Alright, now we need to put in... Oh, I don't think I'm going to have it. Well, maybe I will have enough. Just at the end of my rope on blocks, so... Hopefully that anchors it good enough. Yeah, it looks like it's in the ground. Oh! Boba Fetted right over it. Alright, so we're definitely going to need more blocks. Splat. Okay, so let's crank out... Now, I think, Targus had also mentioned using concrete instead of steel blocks. I'm kind of iffy on that because I kind of like metal more than I like ground up rock and water. Yeah, it's just a visual thing for me, I guess. It's the same reason, I guess, why I don't use wood. It doesn't seem spacey enough, I guess. Although rock is in plentiful supply, water kind of is, kind of isn't. I have weird ways of justifying stupidity, so excuse me on that. Alright, so let's get back up here. We need to build out from here. See, I think it's... like that, and then we need to something like that. And I'm definitely gonna be running out of blocks here in a second, but that's why I've got more being made inside. I'm gonna have to make some more lights as well. So let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4 lights. So 1, 2, 3, 4 should be plenty. Let's see how we're doing over here. A few more minutes and we'll have some more spoiled yuck. And actually, I think what I will do see that do it, yeah. Alright, so we'll finish these up. Ah! Almost fell off that time, too. Oh, boy. Alright, so we got that. Get some growing plots going in down here. Let's see. Yeah, I'll get it in the center, I guess. There. Alright. So far, so good. And how are we doing on that? Oh, 4 more minutes and we'll have a new ship. Alright, so we got some plant lights to put in. About the same time that the ship is done, the grow plots will be ready. Alright, so there we go with that. Okay. So we can mirror this a little better. Or not. Get up there. I think I'll keep that, the outer edges open. It kind of looks a little more airy. And it still maintains a degree of symmetry too, so. You guys that know me, I'm a little OCD when it comes to details like that. So I got it based on the ground. Okay. And yeah, I'm gonna have to add in more posts, I think, but maybe not. I think basically we just do a line all the way across the bottom here to, you know, touching the ground and just kind of skirt it, and I won't have to worry about the insides quite as much. Alright, so let's go see what's constructed. So any minute now, those will be done. What's something else I could do? Oh yes, I'll have to do this with a drill. This was also mentioned in the comments, and I had mentioned had intended to doing this all along, but just kind of forgotten about it. But raising this up just enough. That's decent enough. See, now I can walk up it without having to hop or use the jetpack. So, you know, problem solved. Now I gotta use the jetpack. Now, let's see. Got that part done. Put a door here, I'm thinking, but let's see, how shall I do this so it looks decent and kind of works. I could probably just put the door here, because I'm going to have windows along here. Let's see how far along we here. These haven't spoiled yet. Okay, I'm not gonna worry about that right off. Let's get that up there for now. All right. few more seconds and that will be done. Let's get something to eat here. I'm hoping that that will spoil in my inventory at the very least. Just kind of waiting at the moment. Blueprint production successfully finished. Excellent. Alright, so we got some spoiled food there. This is going to take another couple minutes. That's all dandy. Let's get... ain't going to be able to make all 10, but... let's get... the old dung beetle out. So, F2. And as you can see, it says completed. And we'll let it spawn. And just now it's time for placing. And there we go. So as you can see, it's got the drills. Doesn't have the laser drill yet. I still have to get the parts for that. But we need to get some oxygen. We need to get some fuel for this bad boy. As well as some ammo. And I think... let's see, what's this take in terms of... let me get on it first. There we go. What was it that it takes for ammo? 15mm bullets. Okay, that's not a problem. If I don't have some already, I can make some. Alright. Gonna need some fuel packs. Let's see what we got in the stores here. Alright, it doesn't look like we have 15mm rounds yet. Yeah. Alright, so first of all, let's make... make 10 of those. And then 15mm rounds. Make like 50 of those. Just for giggles, because we gotta fill up that ammo box so that it'll have some ammo for the minigun turret. We'll need some oxygen, so we'll just take half a stack there. Oh, we're gonna have company. Sweet. That's still producing there. Alright, so oxygen. Fill that up. Now I use the cargo box here, harvest box, for excess storage. So we'll put like fuel in here, and then the excess fuel for long voyages we'll put up in there. So we got this fully oxygenated. Now it's time. Let's see how we're doing here. Four more plots. So we're waiting for the fuel to grind through. Let's place these. So I'll need to make one more to finish this set, and I think we'll put in like pumpkins or something like that. We'll see what our seed stocks are right now. So as I recall, I put down the ones I've already planted down here, and the ones I need to plant are up here. So we got plenty of those. Got a full amount of durian, so we might want to just do durians and then corn. Kind of do it like in that order. We'll need to get, the aqua berries, some of those off the trees. Can't think of what else was needed. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And I think there's like 14 different plantable. I need the honey. Yeah, but yeah, I think there's like 14 different plants that you can grow. And, oops. Did not intend to oxygenate. Should be good. good for the moment. Alright, cover that up. Probably should cover up these others with, like these blast shield type things, but this is more utilitarian, non-combat really than anything. The turret is basically just a crude self-defense, and if I'm out looking for resources, I can use it to gun down critters. So it's not a main combat vehicle, not by any stretch of the imagination. So kind of waiting on these and some ammo. So while we're doing that, and these are almost ready to go. Let's see. So we'll need 9, 18, 27 to finish this side. And then I'm going to need, see, that'd be 8. I almost have to double all these over here or something in order to get every single crop times 9. It could be done. I've done it in my solo play off camera. So you need fuel for that. Party time! We're not gonna get there in time to kill, but we can get there in time to harvest. So we'll put these extra charges up in here. Now this thing is a lot more stable than the old Duplo block over here. Whoop. And it's slicker and snot on ice. So I'm gonna have to park her here. And we're going to go swimming. Trying to remember all the keys here. Oh, that's just sad. Alright, rise, Lord Vader. Whoop. And it does tip a little bit, but if you hit the Q key, or if you hit the shift key, it'll right ya. Settle down. Hop out. That's a little bit better of a haul. And then the other minigun drone is over the river and through the woods. To Grandma Shirley's house we go. Oh, there he was. Right there. Alright, sweet. So we got those all looted. Alright, if I can see, I'm blinded by my own lights. Blinded by the light. Becca douche. I mean, deuce. Always screw that song up just because it's funnier. And I'm spinning around because I got locked up on a plant. And I did at one point turn down the mouse sensitivity, so I'll have to retweak that with this thing. But this is a lot more stabler than the old Duplo block over there. Although it tends to drift a bit more, but that's kind of the part of the fun, you know? Alright, let's take my helmet off. And let's see what we got here. I used up a little power. That's kind of be expected. By now, it should have produced enough ammo to at least reload the weapon and get it charged up to go. So, let's see what we got here. Oh, yeah. Actually, let's dump these off. And then the 50-caliber rounds we'll dump up in here. So what I usually tend to do is, let's see, one there, we'll split the difference. Because I got two of these on here just in case one gets destroyed. I haven't had it happen yet, but in case one of these gets destroyed, at least I'll have some ammo to fight with. I probably should have waited. Actually, let's power it on, then we'll do this. Alright, now I'm going to change this from core to turret, thruster, generator, predator. I think alien will do fine. Access. Alright, we got to reload. So we should be good to kill. So just send this back up, because it looks good. Kill the engines, get out, and we are good to go. So right there you have it. That's what I've called the dung beetle, because when you mine, at least with the old T1 drill, and you're digging up the stone or ores, it comes out in balls, and for some reason it just reminded me of a dung beetle rolling up some camel shit and taking it to its hole to feast upon. Yeah, I know. But it just seemed fitting. And that's what it's been named. So, you know, take it or leave it. Alright, so we should have some goodness in here. Indeed we do. And that will be that for this episode. So thank you guys so much for watching. Targus, thank you for your comments. Hopefully, this will answer some of what you and I had commented about, you know, talked about, and maybe it'll help somebody else out with their game. Who knows? That's the whole fun that I have with talking with people who have, you know, see something I do and critique it, and does so in a positive way. Helps me, it helps you guys, makes the game more fun, right? If you're playing it right and it's working in your favor. It's always more fun. So, there. Anyways, thank you guys for watching. Do check out the links in the description box below. Definitely check out the links that go to other people's channels. Subscribe to them. Let them know that I sent you. And until next time, see you later. Twitch.